what might happen if you get frustrated.
Not talk to them, probably just walk away or something.
Okay. So how could that maybe be a problem for a law enforcement officer?
It'd be a big problem because he may try to ask something, but he may also get upset too because he's not getting what he wants done.
Children are difficult and they don't always do what you ask. And it's difficult for us as parents to recognize when is he just acting like a kid and when is he doing something that is really beyond his abilities. So, you know, police officers are accustomed to having people obey their commands. You know, most of us were police officers just pull over, that we would do it primarily out of fear. You know, we see the uniform, we see the car. We have both the respect for their authority and the fear of it. And with Skyler, that wouldn't come automatically. He would want to know why he's being asked to pull over, step aside, move along. And his natural curiosity could be misinterpreted for opposition. And it could be something that the police officer would, take offense at.
The person may appear to be obnoxious and oppositional and rigid and totally uncooperative, but in most cases this is because this is the way this person's brain works. It is not a personal attack on the officer.
Consequences of missing the cues, and it will happen, it does happen, but the consequences of missing the cues can be from benign with no result all the way to catastrophic, where the person flees, runs across a busy street, is hit by a car, or resists you, and all the way to the point where there's fear of the use of firearms, or you could think that the person was going to violently resist you, or maybe they will as they pull away.
I'm a child psychiatrist specializing in autism. I'm medical director here at Vista Del Mar Child and Family Services, and I'm an assistant professor at UCLA MPI, where I'm the medical director of an early childhood autism program.